Hello and welcome to Financial Intelligence. In this video, I want to discuss Robert Kiyosaki's position on Bitcoin. Robert Kiyosaki, the author of the best-selling book Rich Dad Poor Dad, has always been a big critic of how the US government manages the economy and the education system. At various times during the current COVID-19 pandemic, Robert Kiyosaki has been criticizing the Federal Reserve's response to the resulting economic fallout. He has been strongly urging his large following on social media platforms to protect themselves from what he feels is inevitable high inflation and possibly hyperinflation in the future. Needless to say, he is a big proponent of Bitcoin. If you like the type of content that I provide, subscribe to this channel and give this video a thumbs up and also hit the notification bell so that you won't miss any of my future videos. The personal finance guru hopes to minimize the impact of hyperinflation on his portfolio by parking some of his money in cryptocurrencies and precious metals, which he views as haven assets. He also sees them as more secure places to stash his cash. In one of his recent tweets, Robert Kiyosaki has said, and I quote here, that I love Bitcoin because I do not trust the Fed, Treasury, or Wall Street. What a profound statement. I agree with the man 100%. Robert Kiyosaki argues correctly that the last 2 years have changed our lives dramatically. The US government has been printing massive amounts of new money. On January 6, 2020, the US Federal Reserve created around $4 trillion out of thin air. On January 4, 2021, the number increased to $6.7 trillion. To put this into perspective, 30% of all dollars in circulation today were printed last year. These numbers are so huge that it is hard to fathom what they really mean. To make sense of these numbers, let's see how much money the government has borrowed, in other words, created out of thin air, per US taxpayer. Since 2020, the US government has borrowed $10.7 trillion. Currently, there are about 157 million people who are employed in the United States. Dividing $10.7 trillion by 157 million workers gives us roughly $68,000 per person. This means that each US taxpayer technically owes an additional $68,000 because of these programs. And this does not take into account the amount the government had borrowed prior to the pandemic. Although these numbers are not shown on taxpayers' credit card statements, US taxpayers are going to shoulder the burden of these debts. That is because the government is going to repay this money in the future, one way or the other, by taxing workers. In another tweet, Robert Kiyosaki states that, and I quote here, "As many of you know, I believe in Bitcoin. I was very excited when the prices dropped so I could buy more. Unlike most, I'm not using Bitcoin to make millions. I'm using Bitcoin to protect my millions as insurance from the collapse of the dollar. I see Bitcoin as digital gold." Robert Kiyosaki's main point is that we should understand that the US government is not on the side of the middle class wage earners. Since most middle class families rely on only wages for their livelihood, excessive money printing erodes the value of each dollar they're earning. In reality, when the government starts printing money, everybody automatically gets demoted. The nominal dollar value of salaries printed on your paycheck remains the same. However, the real value of your salary, in other words, how much stuff you can buy with those dollars, drops dramatically. Hence, wage earners are all getting demoted without realizing it. Robert Kiyosaki argues that it is important for everybody to start learning to create wealth and not rely on the government when things get tough. He he has always strongly advocated finding ways such as entrepreneurship to become financially independent. He encourages everybody to think outside the system and believes cryptocurrencies are one way to do that. Robert Kiyosaki expects the government's current loose monetary policies will fuel a collapse in the US dollar's value. Eventually, the government is going to be forced to increase interest rates to combat hyperinflation. He predicts that when the Federal Reserve hikes interest rates to cool down the economy, asset prices will plunge. As you might know, 50 years ago in 1971, President Richard Nixon announced an economic plan that severed the US dollar's ties to gold. Since then, the world monetary system has consisted mainly of free-floating currencies. Dollar-to-gold convertibility prevented politicians from printing money and injecting the economy with excessive liquidity. Robert Kiyosaki believes that the era of the gold standard was where the economy prospered most due to the fact that government-controlled money was pegged to a precious and scarce metal. Since that backing was removed, the fiat money printed by the US government has no backing whatsoever and is based entirely on people's trust in the US government. Robert Kiyosaki is also a big critic of the US education system. According to him, schools are not made to help the lower class to be rich. He believes that the system is designed to keep the middle class and the lower class poor, and that is the reason why there's no financial education in schools. Rich Dad, Poor Dad is one of the top 10 personal finance books of all time. By the way, if you haven't already read this book, I strongly recommend it. The book advocates the importance of financial literacy / education, financial independence, and building wealth through investing in assets, real estate investing, starting and owning businesses, as well as increasing one's financial intelligence to improve one's business and financial aptitude. I hope that you liked this video. If you have any recommendation or suggestion, add them in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel, and also hit the notification bell so that you won't miss any of my future videos. Thank you and take care.